Let me tell you this, sisters. Oh, love and save, man. Let me tell you this. Then we get save and use as a testimony. Cause you feel
I'm alive, yeah.
Welcome back to the Cowans family YouTube channel, the channel to be a part of. If you are a new viewer here, please consider subscribing, hitting the notification bell so you'll be notified each time we release a new video. Not only that, we want 500 likes on this video, so go ahead and like this video. Like, press the like button right now. With that being said, let's get into today's video.
In today's video, Sherwayne will be sharing his experience in an unequally yoked relationship. If you haven't watched part one, please go down into the description, press the link, watch part one, and come back to this video to hear Sherwayne's testimony. So, everyone has been waiting to hear Pastor Sherwayne's testimony. People have been saying, Sherwayne, you didn't know what? Unequally yoked relationship? No, sir. This can't be good. So today we'll be hearing his testimony. You ready?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, man, ready.
Alright, go ahead now.
Wagwan people. Mix up time. Lad. So I have two experience. One on the side when I wasn't a Christian and one on the side when I was a Christian. So I'll go with the
non-Christian one first.
So I was talking to this girl one time, you know, before I became a Christian. She became a Christian. I even went to her baptism to show my moral support and all these things. As Kim said in her video, how she laid out the rules. She laid out her rules likewise, you know, that no sex according to her. And you know, being an unsaved, you know what I mean, you know what you know, you know what you want, so you just, you know, nod your head and say, yeah man, if you say so, you know. But in the back of my mind, you know, I had no problem committing to that, because I know that at the right time, you know, when the clock strikes 12, you know what I mean, at any given time, you know, it can happen. Not only that, I was also getting my satisfaction elsewhere, you know, so I had no need to pressure her for any sexual favors. But as I said, within the back of my mind, I know that at the right moment, at the right time, you know what I mean, I can strike, and I know that I will be striking out. But yeah, that's one of the unequally yoked relationship that I was in. It didn't last, you know, because we ended up breaking up, you know what I mean, she moved on. So the relationship never worked out. However, the moral of that story is, or the experience is, that sometimes women will, you know, make their stance as it relates to the unequally yoked relationship, that this now gonna take place and all these things. And while the man might consent to your rules and your regulations, within the back of his mind, or probably in the forefront of his mind, he's just waiting on the right time to strike. You get me? Because the devil is not going to come and tell us, oh, I'm going to kill you, you know. No, I'm going to say, look, man, I care for you, you know. And I'm going to say all of the right things, you know, to get you comfortable so he can get for kill, steal, and destroy. Because even though I agree to her terms, I knew that when the time come, you know, me I go strike. But you know, the meanwhile, to release myself, I would have different partners. So you might be in an unequally yoked relationship right now. You might be saying that, in a pressure me for sex, and I'm better than a Christian man, you know. But best believe it, in a female mind, he might have wait upon the right time to catch you. Forgive you what he truly desire to give you. Not only that, my friend, he might be getting, you know, it's a high possibility that he's getting satisfaction elsewhere, you know. So there's no need to pressure you, but he knows that at the right time, when that hour has come, you know, he'll definitely make that move on you. And trust me, none of us is beyond falling, you know. So in order to escape that falling, it is best that you refrain from entering into an unequally yoked relationship.
So, oh, Sherwayne, where is she now in Christ?
She not there in Christ. That's anything. You see, let me tell you this, sisters. Oh, love and save, man. Let me tell you this. Then we get save and use as a testimony. God Almighty. But watch out, man. Look, man. Just don't enter an equally yoked relationship. I pray that she come back to the Lord. But see, they know me save, you know. What a alabaloo. You know. But guys, I hope you take from that what you need to take from that. My other experience now is when I was a Christian, you know, as I said, I had many female, but when I became a Christian, I cut them off, you know, and left back one. This one that I thought that would have been, you know,
the one
worthy, you know. But boy, I couldn't be so wrong, you know. I couldn't be so wrong. So I cut off everybody else and had this one female that I say I'm gonna work with, you know what I mean. She wasn't safe, I was safe, but she wasn't the type of female that was, you know, out there and, you know, vulgar, and she was just reserved, nice, you know what I mean? Girl. Yeah, probably if she didn't tell us that she ain't a Christian, you're not gonna know. You get what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. She nice, you know, and that all the devil can fool you too, you know what I mean, with nice people. You know, the person not now, you know, be a ranch or, you know, go on with one bag of excitement. Say, I said, oh, one of the
nice cool guys.
Yeah, don't never underestimate one's personality to be that of a Christian, because one can just be an introvert, you know what I mean, and you might say, oh, he's humble. That is not humility, he's just an introvert. You get what I'm saying? True humility is when you have the right to boast and choose not to boast. That is humility. So don't mistake introvert for being humble. See, so she was very nice, she was very low-key person, you know what I mean, sneaky, you know, but me know if you quell her. Going forward in the relationship, you know, she decided to introduce me to her parents. I went over to her house and, you know, I get to meet the family and so forth. But night when I leave, people of the living God, and I want to tell you this, that a piece of feeling take me, Jesus Christ. And we end up sinning against God. You know, we end up messing up.
So how long after you got baptized was this?
This was about a 2 weeks period, 2 weeks after I got saved, or after I got baptized. We mess up. Can you imagine? Jesus Christ.
How did it feel?
I feel like one dead, you know. Even mess up and I go home, I tell you something, that the bus, I say to myself, Jano, the bus I can crash and everybody else survive except me. You know, walking even home from the bus stop, man, I say to myself, I just feel like I throw myself in the crash. Feel like we just walk out near the road, make something lick me, you know what I mean? I feel like we just want to throw any towel, you know? But God said, don't throw any towel. You know, use it, wipe your face, you know? I mean, I have to big up my friend Kevin Palmer, you know, who always did it, failed me, you know, whenever me mess up, you know? Boom! I feel that way about it, you know? But me never confront her about it. I just kind of blame myself as a you know? So, you, cause me, I, let me tell you this, as the Christian that time, I was the initiator of you know what I mean, committing the mess, you know what I mean. I must be honest, you know, and that's the thing about that. That's the thing about it. She didn't put up any resistance. You get what I'm saying? A second time come around now, I said, you know, I'm gonna invite her at church, and I think it was her birthday that day. So I bring her to the community and so I bring her to church. I say, Mr. Church, right, they say, no man. But me, yeah, they're near the church. The devil said to me, go and carry on your bag them. And rest off your bag them. We are carry them.
Take
a bag and pan come to church. But rest your bag, man. Rest your bag and then you go to church. I say, yo, I go rest the bag around the song. Then we go to church. Boom, go on the yard. I rest the bag them, you know. If you leave and go to church, you know, right, this up. Sin against God. I tell you, so me feel like I'm dead.
So you got church still?
I got church, man. But I never go in a church. I never go in a church at all. You're mad! Captain the Almighty God, so. What I do, I stay, man. They say, Brother Sherwayne, come and pray. So, no, not tonight. Not tonight. I couldn't go in a church, man. I feel some type of way, you know. Bring her home, you know, bring her to the bus stop. And I tell her, man, even after I feel a miss and when I bring her to the bus stop, like something raises up and I say, yo, do it again, right? That's when I say, no, sir, what kind of fleshly
desire? At the bus stop?
Sister, can I tell you? YouTube, can I tell you? You know, my pastor always tell me, say that sin has no conscience. You get what I'm saying? Pastor Peter King, he always tell me, sin has no conscience. And he always tell me this stuff. You know, put nothing past nobody. You know, because sin will make people do things outside of their character. And that is so true. Mm-hmm. Sin, boom. Me not like me go home and me feel like man dead. Come here and say, yo, Sherwayne, oh yeah, keep on and do this, brother. I second time this have no sin to save, you know. Yeah, hypocrite, man. I say, I cost myself, I say, man, I call my friend again, Kevin, and I tell Kevin what I go on. People of God, surround yourself with people of God, you know what I mean? People who can encourage you, not some toxic people who are going to drain your energy or condemn you and them things, because as believers, we do make mistakes, you know what I mean? Yeah. So, Kevin, encourage me and say, oh, shall we, you know what I mean? God not kill, you know what I mean? In grace sufficient, you know what I mean? Therefore, no condemnation. All of the scripture, them, that would reaffirm me. That I am still saved and the Lord would still would want to use me and still have a purpose and a calling in my life, you know. So big up yourself, Kevin Palmer. Yo, somebody like your video for that, no man. Like your video for Kevin Palmer, no man. Yeah, man, a true friend indeed. See, in my mind, now, I start praying, I say, oh God, I start all fast and them thing there. I say, oh God, more live here, you know, Daddy Jesus. We can't live here, them away, you see me, I say. Boom. Me easy to condemn myself. Once me do something wrong, me easily condemn myself and them thing. You know, not recognizing the mercy and the grace of God and that He's patient with me. Anyhow, a new year's come. And she come on me yard. I say, this is not going to happen again. That me tell myself. The night there, after Kevin, you know, encouraged me, we pray together. I feel restored. I'm a fast. I'm a clean up myself. I'm a one. Nothing can stop me. Me a preach and no one, you know what I mean? Me a encourage people, me a evangelize. I said, nothing can stop me. I'm tell myself.
Bible college?
No, I wasn't in Bible college as yet. Okay. I wasn't in Bible college as yet. Boom. Me I said to myself, me I go anywhere me I go have her, me I go make sure say, me have people around me. Yeah. So me not fall into that, you know what I mean? The mechanism now.
Set up boys.
Yeah, set up really structure. I'm gonna tell you. Boom. I don't know what transpired. The devil chang, you see, man. My mother did it, my father did it, my sister then did it, people at the yard. All of a sudden, I see my father gone. All of a sudden, I see my mother gone. Then I see my sister beat up and gone. Left me and her alone at the yard. People, you know what happened next. Boom. Against God, and that was the breaking point for me. I say, yo, is either I'm gonna serve God faithfully or I'm gonna continue sin against God in such a fashion? Come on, know something about sexual sin that
you
make your soul feel. And what's so hot? What hot me is because me have maintained a certain level of perfection, I'm maintained a certain level of holiness. I mean, I say, yeah. Yeah, Daddy Cowans, you all have your team. Yeah, you lead soul to Christ. Yeah, you feel the presence of God. Yeah, God, I use you. Boom. Sin against God, master. Feel like all of the work I'm put up to reach and the level I'm reach. Now God has come back right now. I go on zero. You know what I mean? I'm not lying. I feel away. I felt away about that. I got some bumps.
What you did about that now?
After I bring her a woman and say, same night, I tell her, I say, the relationship not going to work out.
The same night?
No, and I did have my New Year's Day. Mama.
Yeah, so the same day, the night, the same day, you tell her?
Not the night. We did what we did in the day, in the night, I told her that.
But she must feel some type of way.
Yeah, she feel that way, she bad. You know what I mean? In fact, the next day, she come and visited me at my place of employment. You know what I mean? So what me do? What me do? And I say, I know you man and me. You see me? I say. But me as a man, you see, once me pray and get the peace of the Lord for the certain things, me just do it, you know. Because I valued my relationship with God over everything else. You get what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. My relationship with God is priority to me. You know what I mean? It's the first thing. You know what I mean? I would never ever put another human being above the relationship that I have with God. You know, so that's why I had to break it. Even it kind of feel away, you know. But again, once we did pray and get the peace of the Lord, it wasn't that hard for me to walk out of that relationship there, you know what I mean? Because like the peace of the Lord make me know so things are gonna be okay.
Mm-hmm.
You see me, I say weeping endure for a night, but joy is coming in the morning. Those things kinda, you know what I mean, help me likewise in that time. So I say, yo, once, you know, me just had that in mind that me I do this for God, I know God is gonna reward me. You get what I'm saying? Me know the Lord I got under my sacrifice, you know what I mean? And in fact, it wasn't a sacrifice. I needed to leave because it was an unequal yoke relationship. This woman did not have no God in her to withstand me. You get what I'm saying? Whenever me knock on the door, she answer. You get what I'm saying? The Christ was not in her to say, Sherwayne, no. You get what I'm saying? Right. And that's the thing when Siobhan and I were courting, you know, I worry about time the atmosphere, you know what I mean, set. Nature called, you know what I mean? And, you know what I mean, attempts now are being made and then one of us would arise and say no, you know what I mean? Say no, Siobhan, we have to hold off. You get what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And sometimes me would have said, yo, Siobhan, I could do this today. You get what I'm saying? And then I even remember one time, you know what I mean, the atmosphere was so ripe and nice, you know what I mean? And I made an advancement towards her. This is why I respect this young lady, you know what I mean? Sister Cowans, my beautiful wife, you know what I mean? She rise up in a prayer, same place, every nature dead. What we say? When Sister Cowan lift up in a prayer, Father, I thank you for the life of Sherwayne and your man servant. God Almighty, may your man, all of a sudden, every nature caught. You get what I'm saying? So, you need somebody in your corner, you know what I mean? Yeah. If you have God in them, if you say, yo, no, we're not going to do this. You know, this is what we're not going to do. You get what I'm saying? That's why unequal yoke is not the will of God for you to be in an unequal yoke relationship. You get right. me? She ball and gone. But a couple months later, she and her new man that apart, you know what I mean? And I make post on Facebook and say, oh, Ray, blah. You get what I'm saying? But see me there and right now, you know what I mean? I have a beautiful wife, you know what I mean? You know, and... You know, God is good, you know. Probably if we did continue in this, I probably would get her pregnant. You get what I'm saying? Or not only pregnant, constant sinning. And not only in a constant sinning in that we're messing up, but being in a relationship with an unsaved is a sin in itself. And that also poses an hindrance for God to move in your life right. effectively. Seeing? Sin blocks the blessings of God. Some of us should be far in life right now, but because of that relationship, the Lord can't bless us. You get what I'm saying?
That's he will true. Not
pour his wine into that relationship, his blessing into that relationship. You know what I mean? He will not cast the pearl among swine. You get mm-hmm. me? Because it will be trampled underfoot. You know, makes sense. God bless you and him knows so you wrap up and tie up with Tom, Dick, and Harry, you get what I'm saying? Who is
that's
not
true.
A child of God. But when the two come together, you know what I mean? That is light, you know what I mean? It is more beneficial because the Bible says, if two shall agree, then it shall be established, you know what I mean? So if me want a house, you know what I mean? In the name of Jesus, Kim just rise up and say, amen, amen. And it is established, you know what I mean? So if me want, you know what I mean? A new blessing, a new care, and get what I'm anything at all. You know what I mean? Because we are a child of God, we have that authority and that right to claim these things and they will establish. So my friends, I hope and trust that you guys, you know, are encouraged from hearing my testimony as it relates to being in an unequal yoke relationship. I pray and I hope and I trust that this video, you know, blesses your heart. Not only that, you know, if you know of any individual at all, you know, who might want to hear this, you know, feel free to share it with them so they can be edified, empowered, and enlightened as it relates to an unequal yoke relationship. So that's my testimony, and I hope that it blesses your heart.
Thank you so much for watching. Remember again, guys, please like the video, subscribe, leave a comment down below, and share this testimony with your friends.